So if you're anything like me and you spend most of your time working on your laptop, then that's good for most of the time, but sometimes you just want a little bit of extra screen real estate, which is where a second monitor comes in really handy. And there's lots of portable external monitors that you can now buy, and that certainly adds the versatility of being able to take the monitor with you on the go. So today we are looking at Plugable's first external portable monitor. This is the usbc-pdmon. So just buying this external display, or really any external display for that matter, just makes working from home so much easier, because now you've got two screens. You could then use one screen for maybe Slack channels or team chats, and then do all your productivity on another screen. Now you can have it in landscape mode like I've got here, but you can also have it in portrait mode as well, because the stand on here will also go vertical. It's not the sturdiest when you do it, but it is functional. So if you had your chat channels running on a vertical format, again, you could have that off to the side of your main monitor. And if you're streaming, then you could also set this up for gaming. So you could put this off to one side and you could use that as your OBS setup, and then you could have your main monitor just for your gaming. It's also good for video editing. I wouldn't have color correction on here because we'll get to that in a little bit, but if I'm using it inside DaVinci Resolve, I could have all of my controls and my timelines on my external display, and then have my main window and my color correction on my main display over here. And then because it's portable, you can also use it on the go as well. So you just shove it in your pocket, well, not in your pocket, but if you just shove it in your bag, it really doesn't weigh much. So the display on its own only weighs about 615 grams, which is 1.35 pounds. Even if you include the stand, that only goes up to 1.85 pounds or just over 800 grams. And it's really thin too, so it's really easy for just shoving in the back of a backpack. And it's super easy to use because it just uses a USB-C connection for connecting your display to your laptop. You don't need to install any other drivers, there's no other apps to install, it will just work. So this portable monitor will work with pretty much anything that has a USB-C, USB 4, a Thunderbolt port, and I do mean pretty much anything. So Macs and laptops and Windows machines, iPad Airs, tablets, mobile phones like the iPhone that I've been using and testing with here. You just plug it in and it works. Now, depending upon what you plug into it though, you might also need to plug it into a power supply as well. So if I plug it into a laptop, for instance, I don't need an external power supply, it will just work. But if I then plug the portable monitor into my iPhone, for instance, I will need to then still plug the monitor into an external power supply because it can't pull enough power from the phone in order to run. Once you do that though, I can actually load up Netflix on my phone, press play, and it will then go and play Netflix on the external display rather than on the iPhone. So if you want to take a bigger screen with you on the go, say if you're going on holiday or if you're traveling for work, that's a really easy way of doing that. As well as plugging this directly into your PC or into your laptop, you can also plug it into a docking station. So I've got this plugged into one of Plugable's docking stations, which uses DisplayLink. So I now can use that with machines and devices that wouldn't normally have more than one external display. So I've got a MacBook Air, and normally that's limited to just one external display. But because I'm using a DisplayLink docking station, I can have the two screens that I've got here. One of the really cool things about this portable monitor is that it has a USB integrated hub. So there's a 3-in-1 USB-C hub integrated into the side of this portable monitor. Each USB-C port then supports up to 10 gigabits per second transfer speeds, and the upstream port into your laptop supports pass-through charging. So it can take in a 100 watt charge and pass 85 of it onto your laptop. So you're limiting the amount of cables that you have to plug into your laptop, which for me with a MacBook Air is really important because there's only two USB-C or Thunderbolt ports on the side of the MacBook Air. So if I used one with a docking station and then one with a power cable, well, I've just run out of ports. But now I don't need to do that because now I can just have one cable going from power into the monitor, the external monitor here, and then another cable going into the MacBook, and then I've only used one port up. Plus that means I've still got one port free on the actual monitor itself. So I could plug my external hard drive into my monitor and it would then be still be connected to my laptop. That I think is awesome. So if you're trying to look at taking the minimal amount of stuff with you when you're being portable, that makes this monitor a really good option. So lots of connection options, really useful, really versatile, but what is it actually like to look at? Because that's pretty important on an external monitor. So the display is a 15.6 inch screen. It's an IPS panel with a full HD display of 1920 by 1080. There's an anti-glare coating on it as well to help with reflections bouncing off the screen. Now, if I'm looking at this here, I've got a light just off to here. It's not bouncing any light off the screen. It's really clear to see. The refresh rate is pretty good as well. It's 60 Hertz, so that's up to 60 frames per second. So not only is it good for productivity, but it's good for the occasional casual gaming as well. Now there's a couple of things though that I think could be better with the display. So I wouldn't say it's the brightest. So it only goes up to 300 nits. So in a room like this, it's fine. Or any kind of indoor space, it's generally gonna be okay. If you put this display out in bright sunlight, you're going to have a problem with being able to see the screen properly. Also, the contrast ratio, it's only 800 to 1. So again, that's not great, but it is pretty typical for portable monitors like this. Color reproduction on here is also okay. There's not too much options on here either with changing it. So on the side, there are three buttons, which generally controls just the brightness. So that's two of them, up and down. And then you've got one other button for coloring, they're changing the different color modes. So there is a cool, normal, warm, sRGB, and user. That's it. You've got five different options. You can see all the different options on the screen and how they impact the color when, say, you're watching a video. Now, I did think putting it in user mode would allow you to then have a bit more options and configuration around changing the color, but you don't. It's just a preset value. Even in normal mode, I thought the colors on the screen were still quite warm. The brightest is in that user mode. You can change it into sRGB mode as well to try and get the best color range. But then the monitor went super dark compared to the other modes, and it doesn't have the best brightness anyway, so I'd avoid that. So at the end of the day, should you buy this? Well, I wouldn't use it for like color correction or video editing just because of the brightness and the color and the contrast issue. But if you're using it for productivity, especially on the go with extra USB devices, or you're just using it with like Netflix and YouTube for casual watching, then this isn't a bad option. So I will leave links to it in the description down below so that you can go check it out for yourself. If you have enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like and share it. Consider subscribing if you're not. And as always, I'll see you in the next one.